GeoStudio 2019 is now available. This video summarizes the new features and improved functionality of the GeoStudio products. The main features that we will discuss in this video include improvement made to the definition of reinforcements in Slope W, which includes new dialog boxes for reinforcement lines and reinforcement sets. GeoStudio 2019 now supports multiple geometries within a single GeoStudio file. Improvements have also been made to the Import Regions command and the Sketch dialog boxes. Lastly, GeoStudio 2019 is now available in 64-bit. Now, let's go through the details of each of these new features and improved functionality. The method for defining reinforcement loads in GeoStudio 2019 has been improved. Reinforcements, such as anchors, soil nails, and geosynthetics, are now defined separate from the reinforcement geometry. The reinforcement materials are therefore available to all Slope W analyses within the same project file. Moreover, the reinforcement dialog box has been reorganized to better reflect natural workflow. The units on the factored pullout capacity and factored tensile capacity have been modified to improve transparency. Individual reinforcement lines can now be drawn or defined. The reinforcement material can be associated with the geometry while in the drawing mode or modified afterwards. The starting point of the reinforcement line can be locked to the ground surface, allowing the reinforcement to move if the geometry is modified. A set of reinforcements can now be drawn with only 3 clicks of the mouse. The reinforcement lines can be locked to the ground surface line, and the length and orientation can be modified after drawing. The spacing can be defined as the transverse distance between reinforcement, or the distance measured in the horizontal direction, vertical direction, or along the ground surface line. GeoStudio 2019 now supports the use of multiple geometries within a single GeoStudio file. The Geometry tab can be used to open Define Geometries, where multiple domain geometries can be added to the project file. Each branch of analyses can use a different domain geometry, such as a steeper slope face or a wider embankment. The materials and boundary conditions defined in one branch will be available across all branches, allowing the properties to be changed only once and applied to all analyses within the project file. Improvements have been made to the Import Regions dialog box. When importing a DWG or DXF file, the imported points and regions can be simplified to remove points along the layer interfaces that might not be needed. The significant digits value acts as a scaling factor to reduce the number of points used to define the individual regions within the geometry. The original coordinates can be kept, or the domain can be translated to have the far left coordinates start at a coordinate of 0 in the vertical and horizontal axes. This will keep the dimensions of the domain, but shift them to start at the local coordinate of 0 within GeoStudio. Materials that exist in the DWG or DXF file can be imported with the regions so that they are already recognized in defined materials and applied to the regions. The material properties can then be defined by choosing the desired material model for each material region and entering the material property values. The Sketch Pictures command now gives the option to embed the image in the GeoStudio file. This allows the GeoStudio file to be moved or shared without the need to update the picture file location, as the picture will be saved within the file. The image can also be moved around the drawing page using the X and Y coordinate boxes. The sketch text window has also been improved, with the options to include borders or add a background color. It is also now possible to change the anchor position to allow for easier placement on the drawing page. These options are also available in the Sketch Tables commands. GeoStudio 2019 is now available in both 32 and 64-bit versions. The 64-bit version will improve memory utilization in large analyses. Two new examples are now available on the website. The first example illustrates the steps required to conduct inverse modeling in GeoStudio 2019 using PEST executable files. The example considers a multi-step outflow experiment and uses PEST to calibrate the material properties to the outflow results. All files and instructions required to use PEST with the example file are included on the website. The second new example available on the GeoSlope website is the pit slope design with multiple geometries. The example illustrates the use of multiple geometries across slope W analyses in a single GeoStudio file. Each geometry represents various slope angles considered for the pit slope design. Thanks for watching, and enjoy using GeoStudio 2019.